faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Of angels sing in exaltation. Oh, sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ. Happy morning, Jesus, to thee be all glory given. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us
to you. Welcome to our worship on this fourth Sunday in Advent, and welcome to the Children's Christmas Pageant. Let's rise and give God our opening praise together.
to sing here? Because I'm going to need your help, because I may sing low, but not that low. But first, repeat after me.
You are holy.
You are holy.
You are mighty.
You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of praise.
Worthy of praise.
I will follow.
I will follow.
I will listen.
I will listen.
I will love you.
I will love you.
All of my days.
All right, this is Ben.
I will sing to and worship.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. With faith in the promises of God, let us pray. God of Advent, we thank you for these days of hope, for symbols and lights that point to the coming of your Son, for music that comforts and gladdens our hearts, and for the voices of children who encourage our joy with a message they proclaim. We praise you and ask your blessing upon us all this day as we prepare for the coming celebration of Christmas, that our joy may be in the child of Bethlehem and the life he brings to all your children throughout the whole world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all communities of faith everywhere as they gather in worship. Make the words of proclaimers and musicians your words through them. Open our hearts to welcome family members, guests, and friends who will come into this house. Receive our thanks especially for the children of our congregation and leaders who proclaim your good news in word and song today. And focus our attention on the comfort and the joy your Son brings to every sorrow and every celebration. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Come to the aid of those who suffer and heal. And hear us as we pray for Dorothy Fristo, Everett Posey, Jan Jocks, Melon Marge Schnackenberg, Shirley Rhodes, Glenda Rose, Carolyn and Ken Carlson, Stephanie Jeffries and her unborn child, Jane Thompson, Jackie Klotz, and all who we lift up to you from this house and from our hearts, that they may live in peace and hope. Bless the memory of George Moritz as loved ones commemorate his birthday, and grant them your grace in Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of hope and life, we give you thanks for your servant, Deborah Lynn Schaup, our blessed friend and sister in Christ, who has entered into her eternal rest in him. Console us in our mourning and encourage our witness through our remembrance of her faithful witness and service to you and to your people here in this household of faith and throughout her journey here on earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Go with those who travel in these days. Bring peace where there is war and division, hope to those in need, and comfort to every troubled heart. That the light of your presence may usher in a new day of reconciliation and harmony throughout the human family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Encircled by your love, we lift these and all our prayers to you, O God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, whose coming is certain and whose day draws near. And all God's people said, Amen. You may be seated as we listen to the word of the Lord, and our scripture lesson for this day is from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 3, beginning at verse 16, read this morning by Ezekiel Schinkel.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Phil, Philomena, are you here?
Ed, you're here, hang on. Can't leave that under there or it'll upset the eggnog ratio.
The eggnog ratio, like to drink eggnog?
No, not the drink. Well, named after the drink, certainly. I've rather had fun with the Christmas references on this build. Eggnog is short for Energy Generation Governance for Near Orbit Oscillating Gyroscope. Basically, it ensures we don't blow up if we get too close to the troposphere. It's a time machine, not a TARDIS. We're not going off the planet. Wait, I'm getting ahead of myself. Stand right here. Close your eyes. Open your eyes.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Phil, what is all this?
Merry Christmas, best friend!
Merry Christmas, Phil. I still don't understand.
It's Xmas time!
Right, I know it's Christmas, well, a couple of weeks anyway.
No, this is the Xmas time. It's the Xmas time, Ed. X-M-A-S. Then the word time. That stands for Xenotemporal Mechanism for Accessing Space-Time.
That's quite the acronym. What does it do?
It's your Christmas present, Ed. I made it for you. This machine will allow us to go back in time and witness one of the greatest moments of history ever told. It will allow us to go back and see the birth of Jesus. You're a really hard person to buy gifts for. I thought you'd like this.
It's beautiful, it's incredible. I don't know what to say. I have so many questions, like, what's this?
Oh, that's the tree. That stands for Temporal Reanimation Energy Enhancer. And it connects with Bluetooth to my smartwatch. We dial in the year we want to visit there, and then we pull this lever. But not yet. And we go whenever and wherever we want. Like Bethlehem in a certain stable where there's a certain manger and there's a certain manger that the baby is gonna be born in. We're gonna see it together.
Whoa, okay, that's the tree. I have so many questions. Okay, what is this?
Oh, that's the wreath. That stands for Warp Resonance Extrapolator to Another Time Halo. It's the portal we will use to physically get there. We walk through it, and when we step out, we'll be in Bethlehem.
Whoa, you figured all of this out by yourself, Phil?
Yep, this is what I've been working on. I built it for you.
To see Jesus born on this planet?
Yep, I figured. Let's go for it. It's one of the most important events in human history. Oh. Here, put this on.
Why?
So we blend in. Remember, this is Bethlehem. Look at the... Look at the pictures from my Bible stories, Ed. Everyone wears bathrobes. It was the fashion of the day.
Phil?
Yes, Ed?
What? I'm anxious. What if we mess this all up? I've seen enough episodes of Doctor Who to know that going back and forth in time can really mess up the time. I mean, what if we get there and, I don't know, we scare a goat in the stable and the goat bumps into the manger and somehow that one small action that we cause changes the whole course of the fate of humanity. What if we mess this all up?
We can't mess this up, Ed, because it already happened. Now let's go see it for ourselves. Merry Christmas, Ed.
Better to ask when are we?
It says we're in Bethlehem, year zero.
I dialed it incorrectly, but you know how these things go.
No, Phil, I don't know how these things go. This is my first adventure in a time. What if we can't get back?
Now you're asking about getting back?
I'm really anxious we're gonna mess things up. I mean, I assume you have a portal gun, or a TARDIS, or some sort of pixie dust, something, just in case, right? Right?
Don't worry, I've got it covered. We can't mess this up. Remember, this is your gift. All you have to do is enjoy it. Here, let's ask this guy for directions. Hello, distinguished sir. How are you today? May I ask you where I can find the inn?
Phil, why are you talking like that? You sound so formal.
It's how the universal translator works. You have to be clear and concise with your language. Here, put these on. It'll help you hear the translation back so we can communicate in Aramaic.
Good afternoon, strangers.
Whoa, it works!
Of course it works. Just listen, okay? We're travelers and interested in knowing where the inn is located.
You are right in the inn. In fact, I'm the innkeeper of this establishment.
No way!
No way? I don't have codes away.
Please excuse my friend. They are from another place. We were expecting to see lots of people in Bethlehem for the census.
Yes, our host is in his infinite wisdom. The census has caused great prosperity for my business. We had large crowds all month.
Huge crowds all month, but not now?
Yes, of course. The census has been complete. Everybody went home.
Ask him if he remembers a baby.
Do you, by chance, remember a couple? She was very pregnant, and her husband, he...
You mean a couple from Nazareth with the infant baby? A son, I think.
Yes, that's them.
They left a few days ago, going to Egypt, I heard.
Thank you. That's amazing.
Yes, I've heard Egypt is amazing. Take care now and come and stay at my inn next time you're in Bethlehem. I'm in lots of beautiful rooms.
Thank you. Now I have to ask, is it true you had put Mary and Joseph in a stable or a cave? I've always wondered about that. Where it was exactly? Was it some sort of like Renaissance art depicts or a half cave with some outcropping of stones, kind of like a half cave with some shelter below? And then there's...
What is Renaissance? You talk very shamefully.
Never mind, my friend. Like I said, he is from elsewhere.
Yes, I am from the land of elsewhere.
Time to go, Ed.
Wait, before you go, I must ask, are the people in Mary and Joseph, are these people important? I regret not having a better room for them. Did I make a mistake?
He has no idea.
You didn't make a mistake. It all turned out exactly the way I was supposed to. Yes, sir, these people are very important to us, and in fact, the whole world. The baby is very special. Very special indeed. It was an honor to meet you, sir. What you did for them will be remembered.
You are the right person at the right time.
What I did for them, I do for anyone. You just don't know who's going to come through your door. You need to offer hospitality to everyone. If this baby is as willing as important as you say, I'm glad to
error. Oh, no, you did not make an error.
This baby was a gift from God. You couldn't have messed this up. Time to go, Ed.
I believe I'm working too hard.
That was incredible! That was the innkeeper from the Bible, the biblical innkeeper, the innkeeper who runs the inn.
Yes, it wasn't all incredible, but as amazing as that was, the innkeeper was not, in fact, a baby sent by God to save the world. Let me see if I can dial it in better. We were, what did he say, a month late?
It's okay, Phil. We don't have to go again. Just that one jump was an amazing OSF. We got to meet the innkeeper. What an amazing gift to be able to stand on the exact same street that Mary and Joseph just walked months before.
This is going to be more of an art than a science, but I think I have it right this time. Dialed in just a smidge back for when we went before. Ready?
Now?
No time like the present.
Let's go.
For Christ is born of Mary.
When are we?
This is a closet.
Hello? Who's there?
Don't worry, we're not robbers.
What? Thieves?
No, not thieves. We're looking for a baby. Are you pregnant by chance?
Excuse me? Ed, we went too far back. This is Nazareth. Who are you? You are a strange farmers. Are you from the East?
I mean, if you keep going, you'll eventually get to the East and eventually get to California, and that's where my family is from.
Ed, stop talking.
Why? You said, I can't mess anything up. You said so.
Yes, I mean, that's ultimately true, but this is Mary, like the mother of Jesus, chosen by God, virgin womb Mary, the Mary, and she isn't pregnant yet. According to my calculations, we're exactly 9 months before the birth of Jesus.
9 months? Mary, have you been visited by any strange people?
Not at all. Joseph's family has been very nice. They're happy about our engagement. What do you mean, strange people? Are you a strange person? Do you mean you?
That's fair. Listen, things are gonna get really weird, but...
Don't yet.
You're gonna have a baby.
Oh, I do hope so one day.
Today's the day, Mary.
Know my name?
Things are gonna get really weird really quick, and then there's gonna be an angel.
Stop.
And you're gonna have a very special baby.
With Joseph?
Kind of. He's gonna be a good dad, though.
Ed, you shouldn't tell her anymore.
Why, Philomena? Isn't this the gift you gave me so we can go back and experience the coming of the Messiah?
Why do you speak of the chosen one? Yes, but I didn't know we would go back to this moment. I thought we'd just pop into Bethlehem and pop back home and watch It's a Wonderful Life later. We shouldn't be here.
We should have gone over the time travel rules at the start. Is this Star Trek rules or Doctor Who rules? Maybe Stargate rules or Babylon 5?
Nobody watched Babylon 5. Do you hail from Babylon?
No, Mary, I'm sorry. I want so badly to tell you how things are gonna turn out. All I can say is go talk to your cousin Elizabeth. She'll know what to do.
Elizabeth? She's so old. What does she know about babies? You know something. You're not telling me. I don't know. What if I mess up?
You won't mess up. You're brilliant.
Time to go, Ed. Wait!
Mary, chosen of God, do not be afraid.
Don't.
Phil, I...
Don't, Ed. I can't believe you said all of that to her. She didn't need to know.
Doesn't she deserve to know? All I know about Mary is that she was young and scared. And this isn't the point of the so-called gift you gave me, so that we can actually go back and witness... We actually can't go back. And what's the point of traveling through time if we can't actually warn people?
You're right.
I am?
It's the kind thing to do. I just don't know.
Don't know what?
If we messed anything up. I don't know if what you said changed the timeline.
Phil, you said it yourself. We can't mess anything up. This event is so important that it has to happen. No matter what we say or do, what happened, happened. You said so.
We should go back and check. We can still try and see baby Jesus. I'd still like to show you. And we can check, make sure we didn't mess anything up. We can see if Mary recognizes us.
Okay, I like that. Wait, don't dial in directly at the stable. Like, what if Mary's giving birth and everyone sees us appear out of thin air?
Okay, what do you suggest?
Let's aim it outside the city, on the hills outside of Bethlehem, that day. Oh, we could spend the day at Bethlehem. Do you think they have kebabs?
We're not time tourists, Ed.
Aren't we, though?
Come on, Ed. The fruitcake powers the whole Xmas time machine, but we only have 2 more jumps left. Let's go.
Hello.
only have one or two jumps left in the fruitcake?
Sorry, my bad. Enjoy your day.
Excuse me.
Yes, how may we help you?
We couldn't help but overhear. We were wondering...
Well, I postulated that you are travelers, temporally speaking.
No.
What? Us? No way.
Then what year were you born?
Twelve BC. What is BC? Okay, you got us, dude. We're time travelers.
Hey!
The truth will set you free, Phil.
How does it work?
I knew I shouldn't have added the blinky lights. I mean, wrangly pencil.
Well, Phil made it. Isn't it amazing?
Thanks, Ed.
Phil can check on the smartwatch, which is connected through the ether. Yes, I follow. Through the ether to the main part of the time machine back home.
When's home?
Let her show you.
We're back. It's 2022 years later.
Two millennia. This is amazing. Who is king?
Let's not get into politics.
Would you like a seltzer?
Good idea, Ed.
Yes, I would like to see a seltzer very much.
It's a drink. Come on in the kitchen, I'll show you.
So, I see you have the gifts.
Yes, for the child king. Gold, frankincense, fruitcake, and more.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
This is magic! The ice! It appears as if by magic from the door of the cold box. It is a marvel, an absolute luxury. You must tell me more of this technology. It's spicy. No, it's tingly.
Do you like it?
I don't know.
More?
I am afraid. I am curious. How do we get back to our own time? I find this place strange and our mission urgent. We must follow the star.
Yes, this is true. We must return.
Yes, of course, it's simple. Though I only have enough fruitcake energy left for two more jumps. That gets me and Ed there and back, but leaves you guys here. Where you guys go back, then we can't go because we don't have enough to get back. And me and Ed haven't even gotten to the whole reason why I built this thing in the first place. You see, me and Ed want to see the birth of the baby too.
As with Herod.
Yeah, about that. I think you shouldn't go back to Herod. In fact, the Bible says...
Ed!
What? I think you should tell them. The Bible doesn't say how they know. It just says they go back a different way. And we don't know what happens to the wise men.
Who are the wise men?
Well, that's you guys. You know what, the three gifts?
There are four gifts.
Four?
Yes, gold, frankincense, fruitcake, and myrrh.
Well, there you go. You can take the fruitcake, put it in the Exodus time machine, and whatever you do, don't go back to Herod. It says so right there in the gospel.
But then, the Bible, did you say? The record book you speak of, it doesn't say what happens to us next?
No.
No.
We don't know what happens to you.
That means to say we have no legacy? History does not remember our work, our contributions?
Far from it. The world will remember you for this moment. They will write books and movies and plays about you. You bring gifts to the baby, and it contextualizes his purpose on Earth. You're very important.
But after this, history will forget us.
It's going to be okay.
Okay? It's more than okay. This is freedom. If history doesn't remember us, we can do whatever we want.
That is a very curious thought indeed. Well, first things first, we have to continue our quest for the star. Please, take this fruitcake and show me how it works.
Here, stand here, and please be sure you have gathered all of your personal belongings. On behalf of the crew, we wish you a very Merry Christmas wherever your travels take you.
Everyone ready? Go!
This was a righteous adventure.
Thanks. I hope you liked it. I'm sorry we didn't actually get to see the birth. I guess I messed up.
Oh, Phil, no. You didn't mess anything up. This was the most amazing gift ever. We got to meet the innkeeper and Mary. OMG, she was so amazing to talk to. And the wise men themselves. Do you know why the birth of Jesus is my favorite Bible story?
No. Why?
The Bible is full of stories about how people mess things up. And then you get a perfect little baby who comes into the world, even though it's a messed up world. God loves the world so much, he built in a failsafe so that we can always go home to him. Just like you built a failsafe so we can always go home.
You know, we could try to go back one more time. I'd still like to show you. I just don't know how to dial in the timing so we can get close enough to the moment, you know?
We could try.
Would you like to go back with me one more time?
I'd love to, now that I know we can get back to the present.
Oh, I'll give you a present.
We hear the Christmas hymn.
And that's when Dr. Einstein said to me, don't forget to divide by zero first.
That's hysterical.
Got any more seltzer, Ed?
Have you ever tried Coca-Cola?
To the market, Ed. Lead the way.
What are you working on next, Phil? Do tell us.
All in good time.
I say this every year, I'm saying it again. Christmas pageants were never like this when I was a kid. And so we want to say thanks for the joy brought to us by the kids of St. Andrew. And we want to say thanks to the writer of this pageant, Allison Fuentes. There she is. Which is to say, there is not another church on planet Earth where you got this pageant, only here at St. Andrew. We also thank Ricky Schopert, our Director of Worship Arts. Sarah Koo, our Children's Choir Director, she's already out there. There's the praise team. There's the guys in the back making the sound work. Thank you. And did you hear me? I mean, I had a line. Just, no, you don't have to clap. No. I'm your humble servant. So we give thanks, and we'll see you next year. And before we get to next year, let me welcome you here to St. Andrew once again and tell you a little bit more about this year as we get ready to celebrate Christmas here in our church family. In your blue notes with your worship materials today, you'll see the schedule of services for Christmas Eve. We have five services. They're easy to remember. It's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. On Saturday, Christmas Eve, and your blue notes will tell you about how those services differ one from another with respect to children's ministries and music and the celebration of Holy Communion. But the big thing is that we welcome you, we invite you, and we encourage you to grab your family members and friends and join us for another great celebration of the gift of God's presence in your life, in mine, and in the world in which we live. And while you're here today, if we can serve you more personally through St. Andrew's Ministry, we want to know how we can do that. There are contact cards in front of you in the pew racks, and so if you want to make use of one of those, you can place it into the offering plate in just a moment or hand it to one of our ushers, and we'll be happy to get back to you. Just a couple of announcements otherwise for the good of the community. Actually, I should make note of this as well, speaking of worship. Next Sunday is Sunday, but it's also Christmas Day, which is to say there will be just one service here at St. Andrew next Sunday, Christmas Day at 10 o'clock in the morning with Holy Communion being celebrated. Also, New Year's Eve will be here for a service at 7 o'clock. New Year's Day, again, Sunday, January the 1st, one service, 10 o'clock in the morning. We hope that you'll come one and come all and join us throughout these beautiful days and on into the new year. We are here for you with good news for your life. Also, today, we share the news that a beloved sister in our congregation, Deborah Schaup, has received her eternal rest following complications from heart surgery in Baltimore. And we will be gathering on Wednesday, December 28th, for a service of thanksgiving. for Deborah, for her life among us, for her final victory in Christ. The service will begin at 11 o'clock in the morning, and that word has gone out to the members of St. Andrew. Also, speaking of members of St. Andrew, please check your mailboxes before you leave today, because your 2023 offering envelopes are there. Yay! So take your offering envelopes and worship the Lord with your tithes and offerings in this new year as well, as we worship and give thanks to God. Last but not least, a request the likes of which I've never made before. If you have a smartphone, you can certainly take pictures, but please do not talk to each other about the World Cup final. There are people here who don't want to know. Pastor Nick Gonzalez, no names mentioned, and others as well. So, you know, I'm just glad you made it. There were some people who came to 8 o'clock who I've never seen at 8 o'clock before as well. So it's kind of cool how God works things out. Great to have a church with four services every weekend. So blessings to you. Welcome to you. May God encourage your heart through the message that you've heard today and for all those that are yet to come. I invite you now as we continue to worship the Lord with our tithes and our Sunday offerings.
Frankincense placed
As you are able, I invite you to rise for our closing prayers, together with those who are live streaming and all those who are part of the church family that we share. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord God, stir up the joy of all of us and all who look to you, and strengthen our faith in your coming, that transformed by your grace, we may walk in your ways. Through Jesus our Lord, whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, who remembers us in his kingdom, and has taught us to pray together the family prayer of your church, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. May Christ, who is the Son of righteousness, shine through the darkness of your path. And may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you this day and forever and evermore. And all God's people said, Amen. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.